Do our children actually need the store-bought health drinks to make them taller, stronger, and sharper? Most of us will be giving health drinks to our children on a daily basis. Some of us may even give twice a day. Do our children really need all these health drinks? Come, let's see. Hi, I'm Jessly and you're watching Jessopedia. Before diving into that topic, let's see what are these health drinks. These health drinks are nothing but malt-based powders loaded with sugar and some additives promising to make your child really healthy or stronger. Some of the claims are even to make them genius. As any other common man, I know that the macronutrient which is most required for growth is protein and not sugar. And most of these health drinks are having almost one third or even more sugar in their bottles. Secondly, if we speak about vitamins and nutrients, they are also very less when compared to the daily recommended requirements. Out of my curiosity, I just went through the ingredient list of the famous health drinks which we can see in the advertisement. On one of the bottle, it is also written that this particular drink should be accompanied with a healthy diet and exercise. The second product which I went through were actually claiming to improve the health or the nutrient requirements of children, but what I can see is mainly sugar. Right from childhood, we have been hearing that drink milk in order to become strong. But what about the children who doesn't like milk? This is one reason which the parents are really forced to give or forced to buy and use this health drinks, because this health drinks come in fun colors and fun flavors and so catchy ads and taglines. By adding this health drinks and some sugar from the kitchen, the milk will be very yummy. So almost all children will drink milk without much fuss. Do children really need milk twice or thrice a day? We call ourselves social animals. I have not seen any animal drinking milk until their last day of life. All animals may drink their mother's milk in the initial months or days of their life. Human beings are the only animals who will drink milk once or twice or thrice a day until the last day of their life. So if a child is not enjoying milk, or if the child does not like the taste of milk, curds, or you can give any other calcium or protein rich food, excuse of making the child drink milk with all these health drinks is of no use now. As parents, if we are bent on giving our children the best health drinks available, our options are not very less. Instead of complaining about the store-bought health drinks and their side effect, now we'll discuss about the naturally best health drinks available. The best health drink available in this world is water. Yes, most of you will be giving a frown already. Yes, you heard me right. It is water. Your child was playing all this while and he is very tired. He is coming back home and telling that, "Mama, I am very thirsty." The first thing to give him or the first drink to offer should be water. Water is very important for regulating the temperature of our body. Second thing is that the water is very important for all the vital organ functioning, including your brain. So if you want your child to be really smarter or sharper, he should not be dehydrated first. Water will actually check on the tooth cavities. Water is also required for body weight regulation. So in one sentence, if I sum up, the best health drink available is water. Second tip is that if your child is not drinking enough water, complaining that water is too boring to drink 8 or 10 or 12 times a day, you can try this new tip. It is infused water. It is nothing but adding fresh fruits or herbs or sometimes even vegetables to clean drinking water. My preferable infused water is by adding pineapples or sometimes strawberry. You can try lemon. You can even try some herbs, like you can add tulsi and all those things. So infused water are actually fun. Just try it. Your child may like it. But one thing you have to keep in mind is that don't add any sugar. The next best health drink which is available in plenty is coconut water. Tender coconut or normal coconut water is loaded with all the electrolytes required, vitamin C, potassium, magnesium, etc. If your child is very tired after playing, he might have lost water or electrolytes through sweat. So the best drink you can offer is coconut water, as it is loaded with electrolytes. Or sometimes if your child was sick, this is the best way to bring back his health. Coconut water is very beneficial if your child is recovering from some illness like diarrhea, vomiting, etc. The next option which I'm giving you is not my favorite, but some of you may like it. That is nothing but smoothies. Smoothies can be made with milk and some fruit, or milk and some vegetables, or even you can add spinach, etc. You can load smoothies with cocoa powder or flaxseed powder or chia seeds, etc. But see that the cocoa powder should be really good. The next health drink which I am trying to say will be liked by most of the parents. Yes, it is unsweetened milk. Yes, it's milk, but it is unsweetened. Unsweetened milk is a very healthy option. In the ad, when they are showing milk loaded with all the health beverage powder, it's actually milk doing the magic. We all know that milk contains calcium, phosphorus, vitamin D, protein, etc. This is very important for a growing child. We know that milk is fortified with vitamin D, which is very important for the bone growth or bone density in a growing child. To sum up, milk is a very common, easily available, and one of the best health drinks. But before drinking milk or before giving milk to children, we have to take care of some important points. In supermarkets, we can see artificially flavored and colored strawberry milk, chocolate milk, etc. We should know that it does not contain any chocolate or it does not contain any strawberries. Next thing to keep in mind before giving milk is that milk itself is a complete food. So if you give your child a big mug of milk, the child will not be hungry for the mealtime. I have seen parents giving children milk as soon as they wake up. Then within half an hour, we tell them to have the breakfast. The child will not be hungry for breakfast. So if you want your child to have a full breakfast or any full meal, give small glass of milk along with the food. So the child can have milk at the same time, child can have food. My favorite option is giving milk as a snack or giving milk between two meals when they are really hungry or tired. Some people or some children especially may be allergic to milk, or we call it milk intolerance or lactose intolerance. For that particular child, milk may not be good. The child may experience abdominal cramps or diarrhea or bloating, etc. after consuming milk. So for such children, there is no need to force milk. There are so many other options. If your aim is protein or calcium, you can give them curd. It's best form. Now we have plenty of healthy drink options available. I can't end this discussion without referring to some unhealthy drinks also. The most unhealthy beverage, which is very common in almost all our houses, is sweetened beverages. These sodas are loaded with sugar, artificial color, additives, and what not. By consuming these drinks on a regular basis can bring obesity in children or diabetes, that is type 2 diabetes in children, and even non-alcoholic liver diseases. The second unhealthy beverage, I'm a little scared to say because you may not like it. That is nothing but fruit juices. Yes, even homemade fruit juices. As long as you're having teeth, you have to eat a fruit. You should never try to drink a fruit. If you're drinking a fruit as a fruit juice, it should be considered as a home junk or a once in a while affair. The best part of eating a fruit, other than its nutrient content, is its fiber. If you make it into fruit juice, you're losing the main part, which is the fiber. So if your child is drinking fruit as juice, he may consume it more when compared to eating a whole fruit. This may fill his tummy. Again, he will not be hungry for a regular meal, and this can lead to weight gain because normally children will not drink a fruit juice without adding sugar in it. I have read somewhere that the American Academy of Pediatrics restrict babies, that is infants below 1 year, any form of fruit juice. The third type of unhealthy drinks which is consumed or liked by most of us are nothing but caffeinated drinks. We should restrict our children from consuming these types of caffeinated drinks, whether it is coffee or some sports drink or any other energy boosting drink. These caffeinated drinks will bring about a restlessness or irritability or anxiety or rapid heart rate or even sleep disturbances in children. Children may protest in the beginning, but we all know that we are thinking the best option for our children and we are correct. So there is no need to feel bad for stopping all these habits in children. Instead, we should talk to our children. We should convince them saying that this is the healthier option. To sum up this health drink discussion, we all know that the health drinks are nothing but malt based. It is loaded with sugar. It is loaded with additives, color, flavor, and etc. So we are shelling out our hard-earned money on these drinks, which are super expensive. I don't know if it is having 1/3 of sugar or more than 1/3 sugar, how it is very expensive. Because as far as I know, 1 kg of sugar is almost 40 rupees per kg. First of all, we are giving our children a full meal, which is very heavy. On top of that, we are forcing them to drink these health drinks, which is nothing but these powdered mixed in milk and a big scoop of sugar. Once the child gets to overeating, he cannot stop. He feels that he is eating very less if we are trying to reduce the portion size of the meal. According to me, these health drinks can do really bad stuff if the child is overeating, if the child is consuming lots of sugar, and the child is not exercising properly. An overfed child may become obese or develop any non-communicable diseases in later stages of life. In one sentence, I can say that by buying health drinks and giving it to our children, we are doing more harm than good. These health drinks may look very beautiful in a bottle or maybe in the ad. Thank you so much for joining me in this small video. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up and share it with your family and friends. Please comment below which is the health drink you are giving your children and what have you decided. To stop buying health drink after that bottle or to continue. Once again, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to smile and don't forget to love yourself.